Yo, what's up? Robert. People requested a bicep video, so what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna start out with a max number of pull-ups, and chin-ups, whatever you wanna call them. That's what I'll do. And we need to start with the weights. Yeah. Next exercise we're going to do is dumbbell curls. And now I have to superset that with the bicep extensions. You see it max buzz here, bicep. But I start off with 25. For biceps, you don't need any heavy weight. Just a lot of reps for the rest of my muscle. I mean, you can use more weight if you have it, but it's whatever. The next exercise is the standing bar curls. I got 85 on them. Just try to keep the elbows in. Try not to use the shoulders a lot. All biceps and forearms. Next exercise we're gonna do our hammer curls. Not a lot of people like doing them, but me personally, I think it's shit. So let's get it. This next exercise is creature curls. A lot of the bodybuilders do this. This is one of the best moves you can do for biceps. It teaches you proper form and it forces you to use proper form. I like to do it without a moderate weight, not too light, not too heavy. So I'm going to use the pull bar instead of the straight bar. You can do it with a dumbbell, straight bar, pull bar, whatever you want, but for the next exercise, I'll do the pull bar or the straight bar. I think I got about 75 pounds right now, so it's a good way to start off with for the ash. The main thing you want to know with biceps is they're little muscles. They don't need a lot of weight. You lose more weight, gain power. Everybody wants to be strong. Like, build them up, make them look pretty. Lighter weight, medium weight, more reps. This exercise is called a concentrated curl. I just want to put back your elbow, tricep area, just inside of your thigh, bring the weight up, pull it, extend. Try not to sling it up, you know what I'm saying? Be nice and keep it warm. I want to do a 45 pound dumbbell. I like to do kind of heavy weight with this. It's my thing. But it's good dudes. That exercise also helps build up your forearm and your grip a lot, so if you like the forearm, definitely do that. Next exercise we're going to do is like a seated dumbbell curls. Basically, you want to sit down with both dumbbells and just at the same time. Try not to swing them up with your arms, just try to keep your elbows down, all your biceps. Do a moderate lighter weight. I mean, these can be difficult. I either do the 20 or 25 pound dumbbells. The next arms, exercise we're going to do for arms, it's a bicep video, but forearms are a big part in your biceps workouts. Gotta be your forearm. We're going to do some reverse curls, go forearms, put your biceps. I got 65 pounds or so, I think, all together right here. Let's try this. Another good exercise for your forearms are doing reverse pull-ups like that, chin-ups. Those also work. I recommend doing all of those. That's about almost all the exercises I do in my routine. All the other ones I do are cable curls, and I do curls with the big barbell, better grip. All I can say now is I repeat that about 3 or 4 times. If I'm feeling really jumpy, maybe 5 times. I go up in weight each time. Sometimes I stay at the same weight twice and move up twice. But it's all depends on your body. So it works for my forearms and my arms. And I'm not doing too bad, you know. I try. But yeah. Thanks for all requesting more videos. I have a back video coming out soon. I'm gonna do. That's about it. Maybe I like the video. My legs aren't that pretty, so. But thanks for watching. Remember the biceps you wanted to do. Form is everything with arms. If you're doing bad form, you're not going to work the right muscles. You're not going to get what you want out of it. You keep your elbows in. And there are some where you grab wider, you know, and you kind of have to use your shoulders a little bit. You see your muscles to go wider. But it's whatever. Thanks. Bam.